When I was in high school, I didn't want to take medication. I realized that I have to.
See, for me, I like just having like natural sleep. So it's just
but
like...
But there's a dramatic difference.
Since diagnosis, it took a little bit to really know which drugs work best.
If I don't go to bed early, I'm more sleepy during the day. And no matter how tired or groggy I feel, I drag myself out of bed and I go for a run for at least 20 to 25 minutes. It changed my life.
I'm Audrey Cross, and I have narcolepsy and cataplexy. I love plants or really pretty trees. That's made me cataplectic because I get excited about plants a lot. And it's kind of weird, and people don't know what the trigger is sometimes because other people aren't as excited about that tree as I am. Getting the diagnosis meant that there was something that could be done about it. My mom found a great doctor for me, and it's been helpful.
Hi, I have an appointment with Dr. Kirsch.
Come in, Audrey, have a seat.
Thank you.
Audrey is a college-age student who presented with sleepiness and episodes of falling that weren't really well understood. She underwent sleep testing, and that demonstrated that she had narcolepsy.
It's really important for anybody with a sleep disorder, but particularly people who have narcolepsy, to get enough sleep at nighttime.
Okay.
A person with narcolepsy should aim for at least 8 hours of sleep every night and on the same schedule.
Number two is napping when you can, because at some basic level, we know you're gonna be sleepy, but a lot of caffeine.
Generally, good health is important. Trying to minimize the amount of alcohol, keeping a good exercise pattern, limiting smoking and drugs. Leading that healthy lifestyle will lead to potentially improvement in sleepiness. Even with a good behavioral program, they're gonna require some amount of medication to be well controlled in terms of their sleepiness and or their cataplexy.
Okay.
There are two problems that people with narcolepsy typically have. One is the sleepiness during the daytime, and the other is the falling episodes, the cataplexy. So let's talk about the sleepiness first.
Okay.
There are two medication classes that are typically used to help people stay awake. One are kind of standard stimulants. The problems with the stimulants are that people sometimes get some side effects. They get a little jittery, they get some palpitations in their heart. We also have a second class, which is modafinil and armodafinil. And these are stimulant medications which work a little bit differently, but they do tend to have less side effects. And often that's where I might start with using that kind of medication first, and if it's not effective, coming back to this older classification of medications.
On a personal level, I try to find a medication that works in a long-acting way as a baseline for alertness during the daytime and then spot treat with short-acting stimulants if I need to.
Then we have the cataplexy. If cataplexy is happening a couple times a day, which it sounds like it is, to me that sort of defines that we should think about trying to treat you for cataplexy, and there are a couple kinds of treatments for that.
When you're talking about cataplexy, you're often talking about using either an antidepressant medication, tricyclic antidepressants, or SSRIs or SNRIs. The newer ones tend to have less side effects than the older ones.
The last medication that we have to potentially try and get you under treatment is a medication called sodium oxybate. It's a very specific medication that we only use for narcolepsy. It also seems to make people's cataplexy much better controlled, and it makes their sleepiness a little bit better.
It knocks you out so that you can get a really deep sleep that you narcoleptics don't tend to get.
With any of these medications, it really is an individual treatment. It's something that you would start as low as you can and slowly move up, trying to manage the symptoms as best you can.
Do I have to take a medication forever?
You're gonna need to have probably some medication, yeah. What I would say is these medications, not necessarily. Remember that we constantly evolve in terms of our understanding of disorders, and things change over time. So I never tell anybody that you're gonna do anything for the rest of your life, because medicine continues to evolve over time.
With medication and better sleep habits, is there a way that, am I gonna be normal again?
You're gonna have to adapt your living a little bit to having a diagnosis of narcolepsy, but what I would say is many people with narcolepsy, when adequately treated, can live fairly normal lives.
The doctors that I've had have really tried to help me be able to live my life the way that I want to. I need to get 8 hours of sleep at night minimum, and I need to have a regular sleep schedule, and I need to have a 20 to 30 minute nap every day. I'm just in sync now with carrying medication with me. I have a keychain container and I keep it in my wallet, and it has backups of whatever medication I might need. And that has managed my sleepiness really well. I've been able to stay awake through some classes that the average person falls asleep through, and that feels really good because I look around and all my peers are asleep, but I'm able to stay awake.